YOLO7 is a fast and accurate object detection model. In this video, we will discuss the highlights of YOLO7, how to carry out inference, and compare the results. There are four important additions introduced in YOLO7. Two are a part of the architectural reforms, and the other two are part of the trainable bag of freebies. Let's understand the architectural reforms in YOLO7. The backbone used in YOLO7 is E-ELAN, which stands for Extended Efficient Layer Aggregation Network. The feature maps learned by this type of network are more robust. Next architectural reform is model scaling. The main purpose of model scaling is to adjust the attributes to generate models of various scales. For example, we use YOLO7 Tiny to generate YOLO7 and V7X using stack scaling and compound scaling. Similarly, we start with YOLO7 W6 and apply compound scaling to generate E6 and D6 models. In addition to the architectural reforms, the training process is also optimized. It is named Bag of Freebies. One such optimization is the reparameterization of the convolution layers for inference. We have explained this topic in a previous video on YOLO6 object detection. Click on the I button to watch our playlist on the YOLO series, which will give you an extensive knowledge of all YOLO networks. The other optimization is deep supervision label assignment. It adds auxiliary heads in the middle layers to help the model converge well. Significant improvement in conversions is seen with the inclusion of deep supervision in dense nets and res nets, which usually converge well. The lead head generates fine labels, and when we relax the constraint of these labels, we get coarse labels from the label assigner. The lead head guides the auxiliary head, which in turn helps the lead head learn better information. The code is hosted by the corresponding author on the GitHub. To run inference, we execute the Python file detect.py and pass a few flags as arguments. Source is the path to the input file and weights is the path to the model weights. ViewImage flag will display the output. Now, let's check out some results and see how YOLO7 Tiny model compares to other YOLO models. The results shown here run on an Intel Core i7 6th generation CPU. We can see that the YOLO7 Tiny model is running at around 22 FPS. It is much more accurate than the YOLO6 Tiny model, which is running at 15 FPS. In fact, YOLO6 Tiny is missing out on the person in the final frames. The YOLO6 Nano and YOLO5 Nano models, although faster, are not able to detect the person which is farther away in most of the frames. It is pretty clear that the YOLO7 Tiny model provides a good balance between FPS and accuracy. Drop us a comment if you want us to work on a detailed video on comparing all the YOLO versions. So, that's all about YOLO7, its inference and results. I hope you like it. Like and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.